So there was this lecturer that always made me feel like I wasn't good enough. So it sort of affected me, and even up to date, sometimes I might even know the answer to something. I might know how to solve a particular problem, but because I am scared that I might not be able to get it.
Because for him, his cells start to exhibit himself in his body. So when it gets there, his tissues, and there's a lot of tension. Then he loses the words and it begins to come all freeze. How has this affected your career? What do you do?
I'm into business now. I just literally avoid anything that would have to make me speak to people in public or administer to people, because I am afraid I will not do well. Even when you asked me earlier, it's not like I didn't have something to say, but I was just sort of feeling like I would probably flop when I start to talk. So I just kept quiet.
Stand up. Was it just your teacher that said all those things to you, or one of your parents also was that way?
No, it was just my teacher. My parents are actually quite supportive and they would encourage you to do better.
They're very encouraging.
Yes.
If one teacher made you feel this way, I'm another teacher. Can I? Yeah. Can I help you change it? So the question is this: how bad do you want to change?
I really want to change, and that's why I took this step.
Close your eyes. Think about all you've lost because of this self-doubt. Think about in 5 years' time what you will have lost because of self-doubt. How to get married to become a problem, how your children will pick it from you, how you'll never be able to close big amounts of money because of self-doubt, and you may end up going back to live with your parents, how you'll never marry someone that you really love because you'll settle for someone that does not love you but, you know, can accept you. Think about the next 10 years and your children are growing and you're seeing the same self-doubt exhibits in their life. Think about when you become 20, now this is about 50. Think about, and these issues have multiplied in your life. And think about it when you're 60. And you sit down, you're full of regrets of all the things you didn't do at 35, at 37, at 40, at 42, at 45, at 50, at 51, at 55, at 56. Tell yourself, that's not me. Look at me. Use a microphone. Did you see what you could have, what that could do to you? Closer to your mouth?
Yes, sir.
You did?
Yes.
Is that the future you want?
No, sir.
Is that enough for you to change?
Yes, sir.
What did you see when you closed your eyes?
I saw perpetual failure.
Tell me exactly things you saw. What did you see your family like? What is your love life like? What is your business like? What did you see with your business? What did you see?
Fear to actually take on big things because...
And because of that, what happened to your business?
Everything feels like...
Your business failed?
Yes.
So where were you living when your business failed?
I'd have to go back to begging for crumbs from even my junior ones and my parents.
You had to... You thought about... You know the reason why? Your mind is not lying to you. It's telling you what the future will be if you continue this path. But let's look at another future. Close your eyes. Think of a future where today you broke self-doubt. Think of what you began to say, what you began to do. Think of, because you broke self-doubt, you could now talk, you could express yourself. You began to do big things. Think of how your business now grew by times 100 in 5 years. Think of 10 years' time and you've grown in your self-confidence and you're double, you're triple. Everybody's looking up to you. Think of who you're hanging out with. Think of all of these great people you're hanging out with. Now think of 20 years' time. Your success have not just doubled, it has quadrupled. Your company is now doing like $200 million. Open your eyes. What did you see?
I saw myself leaving my footprints on the sands of time.
Keep talking.
I saw myself making impact in my business area. I saw myself.
Did you notice his mount is not clenching again? Why are you crying? You're crying because you're going into another state and your mouth is starting to clench again. Did you see how he's moving from state to state? Why are you crying?
I wish I had moved away from this self-doubt to what I feel in my spirit right now earlier. Probably I would have not missed some of the opportunities I did miss.
So you're feeling some feeling of regret, right?
Yes, sir.
Look at me. In his time, he makes all things beautiful. You know what? Maybe if you never had the self-doubt, I'll never talk to you on the microphone. I know there were bad things they did to you, but it's all adding up to your beautiful story. Yeah.